We love him because he first loved us.
Yes.
That's it. That's it. We love God because he first loved us. Somebody asked me before, how you know he loved you? I said, he died for you. They said, when he loved you? I said, when he created the earth. He created us out of love. So he will have some love. So we can express his love through us. So everybody can see his love. So we can shine like a light. You know what I'm saying? Because he loved us. And we love him. So let's go into prayer. God, we just thank you for your love.
Yes,
it's so simple to thank you for it, Father
yes,
God.
Lord.
Because you showed it to us, Father
yes,
God.
Lord.
You walk with us and talk with us every
yes,
day,
Lord.
Father God. This thing, your love, Father
yes,
God.
Lord.
No matter where we are, no matter where we at, Father God.
Yes.
No matter how difficult life is, Father God, you still show us love, Father God. You show us love when we can feel it, Father God. And you show us love when we can't feel it, Father God. We thank you for your love, Father God. Help us to be partakers in your love, Father God. And display your love as you display it to us, Father God. Father God, help us to love you better, Father God, and more, Father God. Help us to grow in your love, Father God, and continue to grow others in your love, Father God. We thank you for your love one more time, Father God. Hallelujah, glory to God. Amen.
Hey, come on, don't stop. Come on, keep those hands lifted. Clap those hands, all you people. Let's lift up the name of Jesus. Because you know, as Peter Martin said, he loves you. Everybody know Jesus loves you. And we know everything he does it with you in mind and with love. That's a good, good father, isn't he? He's the greatest man I know. I know we all may know some people that are good, right? That you would consider that as, that's a good person. That's a good man. But I mean, no one can top God. He is absolutely the greatest. Why? Because he gave his son Jesus. And he gave Jesus out of love for us. That we may have an opportunity to be here today. And to lift him up and to give him praise. Come on, put those hands together. Oh.
Oh,
So we just gonna let this town. We just come to brag on them today. Oh, the greatest man.
Awesome and powerful.
Awesome and great.
Awesome and greatest.
You are the
greatest.
You are the
king.
All right, man, one before. I love this part of this song. It says, we will overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Everyone overcome. Come on, who said, we will overcome? We will overcome by the blood of the Lamb. because he died and rose, he gave us a testimony. So all of us in here, we have a testimony. Just look back at what he's done for you. Just think of where you were just a year ago and what he's done.
Oh.
the living God.
Yes.
And it does not matter what happened in this world.
Yes.
There's nothing that will hurt the church.
Yes.
There's nothing that will hurt the church.
Yes.
There's nothing that will discourage the church.
Yes.
Amen. Because we're above and not beneath.
Yes.
Amen. Everybody in their right mind?
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise God. Father, we thank you again for this day that you have made. We are rejoicing. We are glad in it, Lord. We thank you for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is our Savior, who is our Redeemer, and we are the redeemed of the Lord. And we don't hide it, God. But we want everybody to know that you have redeemed us. You have washed us. You have cleansed us. You have made us whole, God. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for the anointing, God. Thank you for the Holy Ghost, God. And the glory belongs to you, Lord. And God, we give it to you. We believe you to heal in this place. God, we believe you to open up blind eyes in this place. Hallelujah. God, we believe you to cure stomach problems, back problems, hip problems, leg problems, God. Arm problems, high blood pressure, diabetes, blood problems, headaches and migraines, the name of Jesus, God. God, we believe you to heal cancer in the name of Jesus. We command it to be so in this place. Every disease that has been named, your name is above it, oh God. Minds in this place, God. Remove unbelief and doubt. We bind that unbelief in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of unbelief that walked in here, we bind it right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Every spirit of doubt, we bind it right now. We cast you out of here. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Every spirit of deception, discouragement, depression. We bind you depression. We bind you lies in the name of Jesus. And we loose the truth in this house that Jesus Christ is Lord. That we are everything and everything that you said we are, we are. Everything you said we have it. Everything you've given us, we receive it. In the name of Jesus, no weapon formed will prosper. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We are the church. We've been baptized with water. Lord, baptize us with fire. Baptize us with fire, Lord. Those that have been baptized with fire, baptize us with fire. Glory, hallelujah. Yes, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, come on, tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I know. He's sweet, I know. Anybody know that?
Dark clouds may rise. Yeah. Storms may blow.
I'll tell the world.
I'll tell the world.
Yeah.
Wherever I may go.
I found a Savior.
I found a Savior.
And he's
sweet, I know.
Oh, he's sweet, I know.
He's sweet, I know.
Yeah, he's sweet, I know.
He's sweet, I know.
Some had plans to finish school. They had plans. And now those plans were interrupted by the devil.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But God is still God.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Don't you go to thinking that he ain't God. He's God.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And he was God in Las Vegas on that evening. Amen. Come on, let's lift those families up. Father, we thank you in Jesus' name. God, we thank you for those who are in Las Vegas, families and friends, loved ones, those who lost their life. God, we pray for their families that you would continue to comfort and meet their needs according to your riches and glory. And only as you can comfort them, God, there's only ways that you can comfort, Lord. Our words, dear God, are from our heart, but only you can comfort the heart of those who are hurting, God, and those who are confused, and those who ask themselves why and how can something like that happen, God. Father, no one that went to that concert, that event, expected anything like this to happen. but it did. And so, God, we thank you, Lord, that what the devil meant for bad, that you will turn to good, that you have turned to good. We are here praying today because you brought something good out of it. And the good out of it is that some will be drawn to you, dear God, that we are reminded to pray, and we are reminded to lift them up, dear God. So bless those who are still hospitalized. Those, dear God, who are on their beds of affliction, those who have given up on God, we send a healing power there right now, God. That your spirit, your anointing, that the Holy Ghost will move to every room and up and down every hallway, dear God, every hallway. And begin this very hour, Lord, to heal and deliver in the name of Jesus, dear God. Those who are unconscious and coma, God, bring them back right now, God. Right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus, dear God. God, let them walk out of that hospital. God, let them walk out of there in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you, God, for healing the hearts of the family and restoring their lives, oh God. And Father, those children who have lost fathers and mothers, dear God, and those mothers and fathers who have lost daughters and sons, oh God, we pray, God, that you will comfort their heart, that you will fill every void in the name of Jesus. Let us not forget, God, what we're called to do, dear God. We're called to lift you up at all times, for we will bless you at all times. And praises will always be in our mouth, oh God. We give you the praise right now and the glory right now, God. For your word say you will never leave us, nor will you forsake us, oh God. That your present help in times of trouble, dear God. And Father, for that we say thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. That name that's above every name.
Change.
Amen. I was praying the other day praying, and I can hear the Lord say, they don't believe me for blessings because they're too busy looking at television. Too busy looking at CNN. Too busy looking at what Trump doing, amen. We ain't depending on this government to bless us, amen. Listen. It don't matter if Bill Clinton in there, if Obama in there, if Trump in there, if Lincoln, it don't matter. We are looking for Trump just fits in with the time. He fits in with the time. This is the time we in, amen? You better take your eyes off of Trump and put your eyes on God. Hallelujah. I ain't looking for Trump to give me more money. I'm looking for God to give me more money. Keep me healthy. God is my help and strength. Praise God. Hallelujah. My God. They say if you exercise, used to be if you exercise this much time a day, you keep your heart healthy. Now they don't change that thing, so you gotta exercise this much time. You can't eat this. You can't eat this. You gotta eat that. Can't eat that. You gotta eat this. Let me tell you something. I pray over my food and I pray over my body. And my faith, my confidence ain't in no menu, ain't in no diet, ain't in no restaurant. It's in the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. You don't get excited about nothing because you don't have no emotions. And you say, I'm not an emotional person. I've been introverted. I've been quiet all my life. You ought to get excited about God. If you don't open your mouth about nothing else, if you don't shout about nothing else, amen. You don't get excited at no football game, you ought to get excited about God. Hallelujah. People ought to say, they ought to have a testimony about you, and they ought to say, well, she don't get excited about nothing. But when you mention the name of Jesus, hallelujah, you want to see her get excited? If you want to see her open her mouth, if you want to see him say anything, just mention the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on, stand to your feet. Once more. Stand to your feet. Hallelujah. Praise God. I want to get you blessed this morning. I'm getting you blessed this morning. Some of y'all getting blessed with your noise. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. You're getting wet. You're getting wet. You don't even know you're getting wet. Hallelujah. Praise God. Some of y'all are getting wet because of the person standing next to you. Amen. Hallelujah. Blessings falling on you. Blessings falling on you because you're just in a place where blessings fall. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pray in Jesus' name that everyone assembled here will be blessed. I bless you going in. Pray you're blessed going in. I pray you're blessed coming out. In the name of Jesus. I pray everything you put your hands to do, that you're blessed in the name of Jesus. I pray you're blessed in your body. Anybody sick in this place this morning? Anybody sick in anybody in here this morning? Amen. Amen. You sick, run up here real quick. Run up here real quick. Pastor Monique, Pastor Corey, stand right here. Amen. Stand up here real quick and come and get touched. Mr. Kathy, come stand up. Come real quick. Amen. Gotta stop moving slow. You want something so God, you gotta move what you want. Amen. Just get touched. Just get touched. All you gotta do is be touched. By faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ain't no condition too big for God. Hallelujah. Now you ought to say, I'm healed now. I'm healed now. Amen. nobody demanding it from him. He got a whole bunch of supply, very little demand. You trying to get a new job to get money. I ain't trying to get no new job. I'm tired of working. Amen. You think you got to work for God to bless you? If that's where your faith is, God will meet you right there. He'll give you a good old job, and you can work all you want to, and he'll bless you. But if you can believe him, just believe him, he'll bless you simply based on your faith. Amen. The Bible said, a man don't work, he don't eat. You at least got to want to work if you're healthy. Amen. I'm healthy. I want to work, but I want God to give me some stuff that I ain't got to work for. Amen. Anybody else like that? Praise God. Come on, lift your hands. Let's get blessed. Let's get blessed. Hallelujah. Let's get blessed. Put that thing on your mind you need God to do. Hallelujah. He ain't changed. He's the same God. God wants you to pray for those that's in need. He wants you to pray for those who are lost. But God also wants you to ask him for things you need. You can pray all day long for folks that need saving and never ask God for your own stuff. And God going to bless the ones you pray for and say, well, I guess you don't need nothing because you ain't asking for nothing. In the name of Jesus, say, Lord, bless me. What you need? What you need? Whatever you need. Say, you tell the Lord what you need right there. You tell him. Nobody has to tell him for you. You tell him what you need him to do for you. And then you believe him to do it. Don't even ask him if you don't believe he'll do it. Don't think by asking him to help you believe. No, you believe before you ask him. Hallelujah. Every problem, every need, in the name of Jesus. Praise God. Every problem, every need, everything you need, I have it. You have it right now. Believe you have it before you have it. Believe you have it before you have it. Believe you have it before you have it. In the name of Jesus. It's the Holy Ghost that helps you. The Holy Ghost helps you believe the stuff that you can't believe on your own. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Have not because you ask. You ask not. When you ask amiss. You ask doubting. Don't doubt it. God will make a way. Hallelujah. He'll make a way. He always make a way. He's always made a way for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come back up here. Let's pray real quick. Hey, amen. If you have received, we're going to pray for this sister. She's having open heart surgery. Amen. Let me tell you something. I'm telling you right now that you're going to be well, that you're already well. Amen. You believe that? You believe that? Okay. Don't doubt in your heart. Don't doubt in your heart. The devil always try to put thoughts in your mind. It ain't going to work out. This ain't going to happen. That ain't going to happen. The devil's a liar. You understand that? You know why you're here right now? You had abounding grace for this reason. For us to tell you what we're telling you. God has already healed your heart. Amen. Whatever they're going to do with you is already done. You understand? And praise God for doctors, because God gave us doctors. He gave us nurses. He gave us medical science. Amen. God gave us that. Devil didn't give it to us. Devil wouldn't have gave you no doctor. God gave you a doctor. But you healed in the name of Jesus. You believe that? All your heart. You believe Jesus? You think he can lie? Not a man that can lie. Amen. Oh, he don't even know how to lie. Ain't nothing in him that make him lie. We got a whole bunch of stuff in us that make us lie. We we got corruption in us. So you can't compare him to none of us. Amen. Not even to a preacher. You know, preachers lie too. You know that? Because we do that. You know what I'm saying? So don't compare nobody to Jesus. He stands alone. Amen. In the name of Jesus. By your faith, woman. According to your faith. To your own faith. You're healed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The virtue. The power. The power has already entered your body. Your heart is already being restored. The name of Jesus. You may mess around and get there until they tell you you don't even need no more. Messed up with the one she got. You fix it, God. In the name of Jesus. Even if you don't fix it, let it be the way it's supposed to be. In the name of Jesus. You're good at taking things that's raggedy and messed up and fixing them, God. In the name of Jesus. So take this woman's heart, God. Every vessel, every artery, every vein, every valve, in the name of Jesus. Every chamber, in the name of Jesus. Take it, God, in the name of Jesus, and heal it, restore it, and let it be, dear God, the way it's supposed to be. In the name of Jesus, every blockage, let it be removed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Man, I not only feel her blockage being removed, I feel some of y'all blockage being removed. In the name of Jesus, God, take that blockage out of her heart. Open them vessels up. Let the blood and the oxygen flow through them, dear God. That's the way you designed it, dear God. Let it happen like that right now. We command your heart. We command it in the name of Jesus. We command your heart to obey. To obey us. Because we come in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Whenever she feel discouraged, you touch her with the hands. You say, in the name of Jesus. lost. You better get to swinging for what you lost. Amen. And the devil don't expect a lot of us to fight. He thinks he just gonna let him do what he wanna do. Amen. Come on, tell the Lord thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I tell you, some of us gotta get cross-eyed and cock-eyed. Amen. Put one of your eyes over here or something, whatever you gotta do, you gotta get that craziness coming up out of you, amen. You know who you are? You're a child of God. Amen. You are a child of God. Amen. Now none of us, you ain't gotta be rich. Nobody is gonna let anybody mess with their child. Amen. Even if the person, even if your child wrong, you still ain't messing with mine. That's what I got to do with it. Amen. We'll talk about it later. But when the fight going on, ain't gonna be no problem. You get up off my child, he could be or she could be dead or wrong. Amen. When the fight going on, you wrong. But you ought not be fighting my child. That's the way we ought to think, amen. That's crazy thinking it. Well, you got to get crazy. Well, what if? Ain't no what if. The devil ain't got no right messing with your body. None. You are the property of the Lord. Amen. Because according to where them uniforms, they wear them uniforms. You know why they wear them? Because they're the property of the United States. Amen. And listen, you can't even go on Barksdale. Barksdale can have stuff happen over there and never hit the paper. I mean, they like an island. They're an island, man. You can't, I don't care if they're located in the middle of Bossier, wherever the base is, you can't go on that base and do what you want to do. You don't have no jurisdiction. The police ain't got no jurisdiction over there. They got their own police over there. Amen. They're the property of the U.S. government. And we are the property of God. Amen. And this world ain't got nothing to do with us. Amen. Unless we allow it. You think the devil can do something, he'll do it. Praise God. You think the world can do something, the world will do it. Amen. We got to get our mind right. We got to get our mind right. Hallelujah. We got to get mad. I'm telling you, we got to get mad at the right stuff. Our Lord. Get mad at the devil. Get mad at him. You feel a little pain in your back? Get mad at the devil. Amen.